Quite a few people have asked me for a tour of my tea drawer, so I thought I would walk you through what I have today. For many years, I just had this section right here, which is just for colds and flus, immune boosting, things like that. And I have learned more and so have collected more, just as I've gone along. For about the last 5 years, our son Steven has worked at a tea shop and he's learned herbs. And the lady there that runs it is an herbalist. She has so much knowledge. It's just amazing. And what we found was that my husband Brian gets bronchitis once a year. And antibiotics don't really make much difference for him. But we went and saw Kathy at Boston Harbor Teas, and she recommended a set of teas to help him get over his cough. And it worked. He did it for probably about 10 days, and it took care of his bronchitis better than anything else we've used. It just reduced his symptoms and helped him recover. So that sold me on teas, and with Steven's influence, I have collected more and more just for our everyday use. I am by no means an expert. I do use this book as a reference. And so this is one that I'll recommend, and I'll put the link in the comments if I can find it on Amazon. So let's dive in and see what these teas do. Okay, over here we have mostly immune boosting stuff. Slippery elm helps with a sore throat. It kind of coats everything. I think it also helps with digestion, but I'll just go over the things I use them for. Most of these herbs are used for a variety of things. So this is just what I use them for. Elderflower is good for immune boosting, and it also helps with seasonal allergies. Podiarco is immune boosting. Plantain helps remove toxins. It's fascinating. The plantain plant is so good for pulling things out. If we're out hiking and we get a bee sting or a bug bite, we can just pick a leaf, chew it up, put it on the bug bite, and it relieves it right away. It's just so amazing. It doesn't taste good, but it works really good. The plantain is something that I learned to harvest myself. We have it just all over as weeds in our yard. And I went through and picked a whole bunch and dried them and then crushed them up and put them in the container. I'm planning to do more this year because last year I was just first getting into it and getting into harvesting. And it was a lot of fun. It was very interesting. Wild cherry bark is for coughs. Astragalus is immune boosting. Golden seal dries you up. So if you have a lot of mucus, runny nose, things like that, you can use golden seal, but it does dry you up all the way around. So you need to make sure you drink plenty of water for every cup of golden seal tea that you drink. Hyssop is a respiratory system cleanse. It helps all of that. Marshmallow root helps inflammation or alleviates inflammation. Peppermint is good for digestion. I just like the way it tastes. This is stuff that I have harvested as well from our peppermint plant. German chamomile is good for just relaxation and calming. This is one that I harvested as well. Spearmint, I just like the way it tastes. Lemon balm helps allergies, asthma. We don't have asthma. Our older kids have allergies, seasonal allergies. It's also an antidepressant. Feverfew helps headaches, fevers. Skullcap helps calm us. It gives us good sleep, makes us really relaxed. Horsetail is good for tissue repair, hair, skin, nails, and lemon verbena. It has so many uses. They all have so many uses. This is good for alleviating cramps and spasms. And then passionflower is calming. It helps us feel a sense of calm. And common mallow, this is something that I harvested from our yard. So I have I have a lot of it, and it is so similar to marshmallow that I don't know, it's gonna take me years before I get through it because I don't rely on marshmallow very much. So it's anti-inflammatory, but it also has helps the mucous membranes, which means that when you put these in water, they get mucousy. Same with slippery elm. And so they increase your mucus. Stevia is for sweetening, and then I have elderberries for just immune boosting. And then I have diatomaceous earth for when we need it. Here's my extra supplies. I have extra spearmint and extra horsetail in there. My little teaspoon that I use, and then a couple of tea strainers. I keep my wine bottle opener in there because this is all drinks and I don't use it very often, so it's a good place to keep it. In the very back of the drawer, I have extra mallow and then two cups. One is Naomi's and one is Paul's. These are their favorite coffee cups. And there's room for them, so I have left them back there. Then I keep my book and just some flavors. These are all herbal teas that Stephen brought by, just sample items that they had that they weren't selling at the store. And I have yet to try all of them and work my way through them. Over here, I have a few tea bags. And so if I make tea for friends, I can just put them in here, fill it up, and then give them this tea bag that they can use, and I don't have to worry about letting them borrow any sort of tea thing, whatever that's called. Okay, so that's the tea drawer. And then I found at IKEA, they had this. I got it quite a few years ago, so it was under $10, but this is our teapot, and this is what I use if I'm making a big batch of tea. If we're all sick, we all have colds, or we've been around people who have had colds, I will make this and everybody can drink off of it. Tea is something that fascinates me. I love the foraging aspect, the collecting, the knowledge, the just learning about them. It has helped me to focus on just one thing at a time. Like I said, I had all those immune boosting teas in the beginning, and that's all I had for quite a few years. And it's only been in the last 2 years that I have delved a little bit deeper into the knowledge, into learning about it. But I find I don't retain the knowledge unless I use it. So there's things that I collected, like the lemon verbena, and I collected it from my own little plant, but I keep forgetting what it's used for. And so I have to go back to the book. And once I actually use it, like, okay, I'm having my period and I'm having cramps and I need to drink a cup of lemon verbena, then I will do that, and then I will remember, okay, this is what it's used for. So that's how I've had to learn. Like, each thing has been for a purpose, and then it cements it into my mind. So horsetail, Stephen gave it to us when Naomi and Paul had their tonsils removed, and he said, you need to have them drink this. It will help all the tissues heal up and repair themselves. And so that's how I remember the use for that. They, of course, have many other uses. Most herbs and teas have a variety of health benefits, but this is how I've learned to retain the knowledge, I guess. So unless I'm actively using it, it doesn't do me any good to collect more of it. This, for example. And so I have to limit that of, okay, what do I actually use and know about? That's what I'm going to collect and keep in my drawer. And that way I don't go overboard with all my supplies. I don't need more than what I have right now. Unless I start using the other stuff, I don't need any more than what I have. A couple other things, and you're probably asking, where do I get these boxes? I don't know. If I find them on available online. I'll put the link in the video description. But these came from the shop that Steven works for, and they're just old tins that she was getting rid of. And I said, yes, I would like them so I can fit them in my drawer and have them organized. So I'm really pleased with how they came out. I have gotten a lot of teas from Boston Harbor Teas here in Billings, Montana. I'll put the link to them in the video description as well. That's where Steven works. I've also ordered from Mountain Rose Herbs, and I found quite a few different things at natural grocers that were really reasonable. I got a big bag of the passion flower, which is what I use a lot of, and different things that I use a lot of. It was very reasonable and I could fill up my tins. So thanks for joining me on this quick tea drawer tour. I hope you enjoyed it. I'd love to know if you are a tea drinker and if you use medicinal teas, what exactly you use and what you use them for. I realized last night after I had recorded the tea drawer video earlier in the day that I went through all of that and I didn't actually show you how I make a cup of tea. So let's do that now. I use filtered water. So I get my little tea infuser thing and I have my spoon. It's probably about the same as a half teaspoon, but if I make a big pot, I use a teaspoon of each thing. So most of the time I go for passion flower because I want to feel calm. And if I feel like I'm getting sick, I'll add in a little bit of astragalus root or plantain or elderflower, anything. And then I like spearmint for flavor, so I'll do a spoonful of that. And I like a little sweetness without using sugar or honey, so I'll add a little bit of stevia. I then let this steep for about 3 minutes. And when it's done steeping, I set it in a container. Just because you can make more tea off of this for 48 hours. It does tend to lose its flavor, but it is still effective if you're going for medicinal use. It is effective. And you can make several cups off of it. I don't remember what it is. I think it's 6 to 8 cups off of tea. So I have that for when I want another cup of tea. And then this one is nice and hot and ready to drink. So all of the teas that I have in here, when I'm making something, I use 1 spoonful or about a teaspoon of the dried herb. Except for things that, like the astragalus root, is bigger chunks. Sometimes it's ground up and more flaky, and so then I will use more. But when it's the roots, it's very dense, and so I use about 1/2 teaspoon. And the same with the wild cherry bark. If I'm using that for a cough, I just use 1/2 teaspoon of that. It was, I don't know, that's what Steven told me to do. So there you have it. One of the reasons I can have a full drawer dedicated to my tea collection is because I simplified so many other areas of my kitchen. And if you would like to see what 10 areas made a huge difference in my kitchen, you can check out this video right here.